Hey guys, today is our topic about ion channels. Ion channels are channels through which ions can enter into cell membrane. Cell membrane is divided into extracellular membrane and intracellular membrane. Cell membrane is made up of the phospholipid bilayer. We have specific receptor hormones, ions in our body, and these hormones and ions can't enter through the phospholipid bilayer. So for the entry into the cell, it is necessary to have a specific gate. And we know that this one is extracellular membrane and this one is intracellular membrane. If extracellular membrane is closed by a specific gate, then no entry will be occur of neurotransmitter, no entry will be occur of a drug, no entry will be occur of ions. And if this extracellular membrane gate is open, but it is closed from inside, it is also then not enter into the cell. So it is necessary for the entry into the cell that this gate should be open from both sides. And so that it is divided into the two types. First one, there is ungated ion channels and gated ion channels. If we come here into ungated ion channels, ungated ion channels are channels which are open into the extracellular membrane as well as into intracellular membrane. When it is open from both sides, then easily can enter ions, neurotransmitter from this gate because this is open always. And for the entry of these ions from the ungated ion channels, there is a specific electrochemical gradient. What's the main role of electrochemical gradient? Electrochemical gradient is a gradient mean that the ions will diffuse from high concentration to low concentration. For example, we know that sodium is high concentration, nearly about of the 140 in outside the cell membrane, but it is present inside the membrane nearly about of 10. And potassium is present out inside the cell membrane in large amount. So according to the electrochemical gradient, ions will move from high concentration to low concentration. So sodium will enter into the cell membrane, not from inside to the outside of the cell membrane. And potassium will move from inside cell membrane to outside cell membrane because potassium is nearly about 150 milliequal per liter. These are present inside the cell membrane 150. So there's high concentration of the potassium inside of the cell membrane, and according to electrochemical gradient, the potassium will move from inside the cell membrane to outside the cell membrane. Ungated channels play main role into maintain of resting membrane potential. What's mean of the resting membrane potential? Resting membrane potential, it is a potential at which the cell is at rest. For example, when equal amount of the sodium will be entered into the cell and equally amount of the potassium will go out from the cell, then there's maintain of a equilibrium. When there's maintain of a equilibrium, then it's known as a resting membrane potential, and at this condition the cell will be at rest. And if again I come, ungated ion channel play main role, always open. First one, these are always open. These move according to electrochemical gradient. I have explained about electrochemical gradient, and this also play main role in maintain of resting membrane potential, RMP. So second type of ion channels is gated ion channel. Gated ion channel is further divided into two types: voltage gated ion channel and ligand gate ion channel. Ligand gate ion channel. Every cell have a specific voltage. Every cell allow the entry of the neurotransmitter or the drugs or ions. And example, this one is voltage gate channel. And this one is gate. This one is gate. And here I will give you an example of a door. For example, if you lock a door from outside the room, then no one can enter to the cell. So if we lock or if we close from outside the cell membrane, sodium will not enter into cell membrane. And if we close the door from inside, and then also no one can enter into the room. And for example, this one is open now and this one is closed. Sodium will also not enter into the cell membrane. So it is necessary for the entry of the any ions that the gate should be open from both sides, and these gate open at a specific voltage. Sodium has a specific voltage for the entry into the cell. Potassium has a specific voltage for the entry of the cell. Calcium has a specific voltage for the entry of the cells. Every ion have a specific voltage for the entry to the cell. So the next one is we will discuss about the ligand gate channel. Gate channel are the channels which have a specific receptor for the opening. For example, this one is a gate and this have a specific receptor. When any drug or the any neurotransmitter will bind with a specific receptor, then the structure of this gate will be changed and then the drug will enter into cell membrane or into the cell. For example, I will give here example that a specific key only open a specific door, so that every cell have a specific receptor and every drug have a specific receptor for the entry into the cell membrane or entry into the cell. So if we come here into the quick review, ion channels are divided into ungated and the gated. Ungated always open, and these main row according to electrochemical gradient mean that they will allow the entry of the sodium or ion from high concentration to the low concentration. These play main role into resting membrane potential. And if we come here, the gated ion channels are divided into voltage and ligand gate channel. Voltage gate channel have a every cell have a specific voltage for enter to the cell, and ligand gate channels, there is present of the specific receptors onto the gate. If a drug or the neurotransmitter will bind to the receptor, then the structure of the receptor will be changed, and then it's allowed the molecule or the drugs or the neurotransmitter enter to the cell. This is all about the ion channels.